Hey, what's up? This is Doug with Design 8 Studio, and I've been learning about G codes with regard to zeroing out before starting a job in a 0 point different than the machine's physical home coordinate zero, and specifically as it might have to do with use of the pendant that is currently under development by the FluidNC development team. And so in discussion with Ryan and others on the V1 Engineering Forum, we've been talking about the fact that hard limits and soft limits are nice if you can use them, but the dangers to be wary of with regard to trusting them when you've actually lost their functionality because you set a different zero than your machine's zero. And in specific, why several folks are warning me against zeroing out by use of a G code that is G92, and whether or not use of a G code of G10 might be better. Before I actually do the test of whether the hard limits and soft limits can survive setting a different zero with G10, and presumably that's what zeroing with this FluidNC pendant would do, let me first show you what the soft limits and hard limits look like for not using any alternate zeroing at all. So first, let me go ahead and change to jogging, and I'll switch from knob jogging to button jogging. And in that mode, spinning the dial changes the rate of the jog. So I've set it to 10,000. I'm going to, let me go back to first home of the machine. From the main screen, home is green. That means the green button does it. I'm to the homing screen now. And you can see again, the green button actually does the home all. So you saw it there, but let me show you what it looks like on here. These little radio buttons beside each axis light up when that axis end stop switch is triggered. Let me home all again. You saw the green light on the Z. Now you see both the X and the Y happening together. They can happen separately if they're staggered apart. So now we're homed. I'm going to go back to the main screen and I'm going to go to jogging. I'm in button jog mode at a rate of 1,000. So green gives me positive movements. Red button gives me negative movements. Now I have the size of my table programmed into my config.yaml file, and I have soft limits enabled, and I have hard limits enabled. Hard limits means that I can't drive past an end stop, and soft limits means I can't drive past the far end of the table on the opposite end of the end stop. So I'm going to jog over in X, and now when I go to jog back in X, you'll see just that quick I moved 148.5. When I go to jog back, you'll see I can keep the button pressed and it won't go past the end stop. So I'm still holding the button down, but it wouldn't go past the end stop. And that's because hard limits are enabled. Now I can tap on the center to change from X to Y. And now if I do the green, you'll see the carriage move across, and please forgive me, my X and Y are switched from yours. So if you were doing this, then what you're about to see would have happened first, and what you just saw would have happened second. Let me increase the rate from 1,000 up to a higher number. Now you'll notice I can keep the button held, and it automatically stops at the far end as opposed to crashing in, and that's because the soft limits are enabled. So again, let me swing it back over. This time you'll be seeing hard limits come into effect. That's an automatic stop because of a hard limit, and on the far end was an automatic stop because of a soft limit. So this is a wonderful feature. The question is, can I set a zero for a work job and still have those respected? So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to switch from button jogging to knob jogging, and now the buttons change the increment. So my jog distance for Y is now 10, and I'm going to jog just that little nudge of the dial took me that increment times 3. So I'm now at 30, and I'm going to switch to the zero mode. With another tap, I switch to the zero mode, and the green button will now zero my Y at that location. Okay, then I'm going to tap to cycle back to X, and I'm going to change that increment. I'm going to change that increment to 10. All right, just like that, I went over 20 millimeters in the X direction. I'm going to tap once more to go to the zero mode. And now a green button press will zero my X. So now that I've used a soft reset of my zero in the X and Y, the question is, did I lose my soft and hard end stops? So I'm going to go back to button jogging, and I'm going to swing the Y, which for most of you would be X. And the question is, it going to crash, or will I still have soft stops, soft limits? And the answer is, I still have soft limits. And I still have hard limits, and you see it went into a negative number to get there. This is very good news, and I think it's what Ryan is hoping for. So I'll get this video posted up. This has been Doug with Design 8 Studio, and until the next video, I wish you happy making.